Hey boys, hey girls, welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes. One of my furnaces went out, and so I had to fire up my fireplace, but I had to get it ready. We hadn't used it in years, so I had to clean it out good and get some wood and fire it up. Gonna be replacing my furnace probably either starting next week. We just real busy at work. This is a little insert type fireplace with a gas log in it. This is a Heat-O-Later brand. And it's got a little forced induction fan to get the heat out of the system. And it blows the heat out into the room. And they'll cook you from across the room. First thing you got to do is remove the ash from the unburned wood. So let's get started with that. I'm sorry, from the burned wood. Got to make sure your flue is open. Which on this one, there's a lever. Sit right there. It's closed. That's open. So we've got to clean up and get that unburned ashes and embers, pieces, parts out of there. So if there's any savable pieces, put them down there on the side. The rest of it looks like junk. Go ahead and remove your fire holder or wood holder. Get it out the way. Now everything in here is cool. In other words, this is not hot. You don't want to do this when it's hot, boy. You want to use something to catch all this ash in. Go ahead and scoop it out to a metal container. Don't put it in plastic. And don't put this container down on carpet because it'll melt it. Maybe catch it on fire. And you want to do that. And this one has a gas log in it. So we want to try to prevent ashes from getting in there and then brush the gas log off. Whatever pieces of wood are still on top of that gas log, get them off of that. Ash and shit like that. You know, come on, boy. Let's get all of this crap out of there. Or as much as we can.
Yeah, the metal shovel is out on the patio by the barbecue pits. So the ashes could still be hot from yesterday.
So now that you're all proud of yourself, Hazel, put that down in there. Check it again. Now, our chimney is cold, so we're going to flash it. First thing we're going to do, turn the gas on. Light the gas. And I modified that gas log, as you can see. But don't worry about that. Just use the gas log like it is. Now, if you got a built-in, they normally burn like that. But I modified it to where we can get more fire out of it. That's about all that can take. Now, if you got a real built-in wood fireplace, you still need to heat your chimney up. So you can do that a couple different ways. Just throw the wood in there and light it on fire, best way you know how. But with these types, it's got a metal chimney, best to take some newsprint and flash that chimney, get some heat up in there.
son of a bitch. So let's flash it. Whoa, good. You probably hear it pop in a second. Get this crap out the way. We don't need you no more. Now, I should have put this in before I lit that fire, but that's too bad. Now, put your seasoned firewood in there with the pieces you saved from the last fire you built. Any little small parts you got like that, pieces, parts. Kind of like that fast food chain. And I got some wood from a good friend of mine, but he left it sitting out in the rain and it got wet. But it is seasoned. Been split for a while and it's oak. So if you don't flash that chimney to get it good and hot, it's going to start smoking back in the room. And it can set your fire alarm off. And you don't want that bullshit. So let's let that ignite a little bit. And we come back in a second. Now if you're in a hurry, put the driest pieces on first. And start with some smaller ones. And go on and chuck them on them. And this is not, like I said, a big brick fireplace. This is a, used to be a welder. I can handle the hot. This is an insert. And the fire brick liner that's inside ain't that thick like a real brick fireplace. See how wet that wood is from sitting out in the rain?
Todd, you get a damn it, boy, for letting that wood get wet.
I know he's watching this video, too. So go on and put it in there. And eventually you're going to have a nice rolling fire. And that gas assist lighter log really does help with wet wood like this. So, do keep this shut, because if it starts popping, you don't want them embers flying out on your carpet, or your cat, or your dog, or your ass if you curl up in front of it here on the brick. Now, if you're in a goddamn hurry, and you won't get that thing on, don't be afraid to crank that gas log up. Ain't gonna hurt nothing. It's your roaring fire in there. Now I remember I modified that log. Added more holes, drill an orifice out. It'll rock now. Put some propane on it, it'll really kick butt. Before too long, you have a nice rolling fire in there. Warm up the room. Put you some popcorn or some chestnuts in there and roast them. A boy.
Or get you a cup of hot chocolate, sit in a rocking chair and take a nap. Keep your toes warm, young. Huh? There you go. Let's move on.
Okay, hope y'all learned something.
I know y'all probably want some food, so I made some French dips, which are simply roast beef with au jus, and you dip it in there with provolone cheese.
and mayo and eat. Yum.
So we're going in over here at Al Bastion's Greek Lebanese Restaurante.
This over the last few days, we went back to Al Bastion. Man, they got fantastic food. I mean, fantastic. But I've eaten everything on the menu. It's all been great. And also went to Pocarella's. And I've shown some of these shots before. And they sell their meatballs and Italian sausage and red gravy separately. And you can, there it is in a restaurant. You can buy it already. Or they sell it cold. And you can take home and cook it and reheat it and eat it. And yum. They also got some of the best muffalettas in town. Oh my God. Yum.
Bye, a boy, a girl. A boy, a girl, a bye. That's it. I got it right, see?